you did. Now the world's saying you're wrong, and it's not looking like you thought it would look. They're actually more so understanding what Joe's going through.
Well, then someone needs to help him then. Shaq, can he get a Papa John's?
Wow. Okay. Case that was wrong. Joe.
Yeah, I'm out, y'all.
Joe.
I'm out, y'all.
Case. What was wrong about that?
Now, Joe. Nigga, why did you go to Keenan Ivory Wayne's, man, to go talk to your bitch, man? You know what I'm saying? You done left this bitch in the room with Keenan Ivory Wayne's. Now, brother, you need to get around some real niggas, man. You a 16-year NBA vet. You've been on 12 NBA teams. You was at 2 years of college, man. You can get a job anywhere. You got homeboys as coaches, man. You got relationships with the NBA players, man. Go get you a job, brother. You could be doing way better than this bitch on OnlyFans.
My guy, the MVP. Bell, what's going on, my guy?
What's up, fellas?
What's going on, MVP? And we man. Got...
The sensei has entered the dojo. If y'all want to know why I'm so radicalized, there you go. Here you go, right here.
And we got... Bella B, the sister, little sis, is definitely in the house. What's up?
Yeah, man, I heard BT say my name, man. I said, fuck it, man. Let me get on here, man. Because don't nobody know nothing about this shit, man. You know, as much as me, man. You know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck. Right. Ain't a nigga right on the internet, no... Got the intelligence of a bitch. Ain't got the experience of fucking with bitches like the Bell.
Blocked.
So
he's getting blocked, y'all. He's getting blocked.
Block me and flag me, whatever you want to do. You know what I'm saying? If you don't want to hear the truth, keep complaining about these bitches and keep tricking.
Yo, what's going on, Sister Bella B? What's going on, sis?
Not much. Appreciate the love, but I was just like homegirl doing too much.
Was that what it did? How you doing today?
I'm doing good, guys. Good to see here and see y'all, whatever. But it's good to be here.
No doubt.
What?
But or listen and go, oh, so I like only fans, you know what I mean? Sure. But I did something. I talked to my husband about he found out about it,
right?
And I kind of like just
right
help expose it
because
mm-hmm he was mad and mm-hmm I was mad about something else,
mm-hmm,
so I just like you
exactly. Okay,
and then it helped my OnlyFans just
really
get bigger, and now I'm like really having fun because I get to watch all kind of cool get to do cool so
for sure. So You recently went viral for live streaming the moment that your husband found out you had an OnlyFans.
Yeah, sorry.
What made you like decide to record that convo?
Well,
all right, bro.
Prior to me starting to film, we were
want to know why Zion Williamson and PJ Washington will be quick to fight a nigga over their bitches, especially when their bitches act like this. The niggas living in denial, bro. You see how she even revealed to Joe Smith, if I remember her saying it correctly, how she's admitting to Joe Smith that she living like this. Bro, these dudes, they can't get past the sex. Remember how during that baby shower, how Zion gave that long monologue about how proud he is to be a daddy, but that stripper bitch, he got pregnant? She didn't say a single word. In fact, she was looking at him like the same way you look at a comedian because you think they're funny. That's what it is, bro. Like, she don't take Joe seriously at all. That stripper that Zion got pregnant, she don't take him seriously at all, which, you know, I mean, you hear Zion talk, it's kind of hard to do so. And then same thing with PJ Washington. Like, they all get angry when you tell them about the truth about these females. But the problem is, bro, all you're doing is telling them from prior experience. These dudes don't want to learn shit.
BT.
What's down?
Why would they take them niggas serious? I mean, if you a trick, why would you be? Why do you think you should be taken serious just because you a trick? And you're infatuated with these type of hoes.
That part.
Man. I mean, the thing is, you got so many niggas on the internet complaining about hoes and complaining about the way bitches are, but you attracted to them type of bitches. You know, you got square ass niggas like Kevin Samuels telling you to get a fit, feminine, friendly bitch or whatever the case may be, and then leave with your wallet. And then pay for everything and don't let a bitch pay for nothing and don't expect nothing out of her besides her going to make you a sandwich or whatever kind of stupid ass explanations these niggas be having or whatever the expectations they have on a bitch. But the thing is, why are these niggas so infatuated with strippers and hoes when they don't treat a bitch at Subway special? And take her out of poverty or you know what I'm saying? You trying to it's something about the trick and the square ass nigga that's infatuated with bitches that entertain other men. And it's some weird shit because these niggas tend to get to crying and complaining and talking about they want a traditional woman, but they focused on the modern bitch. And then you got these dumbass trick niggas that, you know, I guess it gets expensive for them niggas to buy pussy in America. So they want to go overseas and do all that tricking and fuck with lady boys and shit. And you know what I'm saying? And keep their secrets over there and then come over here and then try to promote telling niggas to go over there because they're getting treated like kings. But them bitches over there that's supposedly treating them like kings ain't coming over here to get these niggas. You know what I'm saying? It's some weird shit. But this bitch right here, she ain't doing nothing but marketing herself. You know what I'm saying? She's using this platform to market herself to get motherfuckers to come over and see her OnlyFans or log on to her YouTube shit or whatever the fuck she got going on. That's all these bitches do is go from platform to platform to market themselves. You know what I'm saying? The bitches get books out. Then they're going to go over to different platforms and talk this stupid shit. And try to entice motherfuckers and see her attitude right now. Remember, she was a porn star. So she's somewhat of an actor and she's acting to where, you know, she got that airheadish attitude or whatever the case may be. And it makes it look seem like it's easy to get her or whatever. That's enticing to a trick. That's enticing to a square ass nigga because they sit around
that earlier.
They sit around and watch Pornhub. They sit around and watch, you know, a porn where it ain't, you know, it ain't a good amount of acting. And then you get right to the pussy. Right. You know what I'm saying? Right. So that's enticing to a trick nigga. And like say these athletes like Joe Smith and Zion or whatever, you know what I'm saying? These niggas probably didn't have a lot of experience dealing with females as I was growing up playing basketball or being in the hood and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Cause most niggas that grow up in the hood, they're limited to the females that surround them. Most of them don't got a lot of fine bitches around because they're around a lot of poverty and they're around a lot of teen pregnancy and gang banging and shit like that. So those females tend to miss the square nigga. Cause they got their eye on the gang member and the nigga that's selling dope and you know what I'm saying? And driving a flashy shit, whatever the case might be. Cause they trying to get out of poverty too.
Right.
So when these niggas start touching money, now they can touch their fantasy. Now that they can afford to pay for that bitch that they was fantasizing about. You know what I'm saying? That they seen in videos. Now they able to be in the parties and be in the events where good looking females are. But see, them niggas never, they brought the money, but they never had the game. Because the thing is about the game has always been hated on by a bunch of square ass niggas bitches, and lame ass niggas. So these niggas always got the game skipped over them because they was always hating on it. You see what I'm saying? Because anytime you mention pimping, you mention you get a bunch of square ass niggas saying some little dumb ass comments, and you got some bitches that's hating on it. Because a lot of bitches, first of all, every female got the spirit of a prostitute in them. And that shit is contagious.
Preach, preach.
And I don't give a fuck what kind of female you. What?
Go ahead, bro. It's hot. Let's go.
I don't give a fuck what kind of female you are, church female, whatever the case may be, that spirit of prostitute is in you. It only take a price. Right. You know what I'm saying? Some low, some high. But it only takes a price. You know what I'm saying? As far as a man to qualify for you, you know, he got to be doing good. He got to be, you know. Now we talk about the six-figure nigga and all this other type of shit. So it ain't really about the quality of a man, because you never hear about the qualities of a man, the integrity. He's a hard worker. He's this, he's that, he's loving, he's caring. No, it's about what a nigga can provide. And black women do black men terrible, you know, with this, because if anybody should know a black man's condition, it should be a black woman.
Exactly.
If anybody should know how we all came up, it should be a black woman. You know what I'm saying? So hear about, you know, these black women on here, man, talking shit about niggas and all that, whatever the case may be. And then you get surprised when this nigga starts fucking with another type of female, another ethnicity. You know what I'm saying? Who want to hear you talk about niggas ain't shit? Who want to hear you talk about, you know, a dusty nigga? Who want to hear you talk about a nigga like that? You know what I'm saying? Any nigga that will stick around and listen to that type of shit, he's a fool. You know what I'm saying? And most niggas that do have already been beat into submission by their mamas for just accepting this type of shit. You know what I'm saying? Any nigga in their right mind would want to get away from that shit. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, it's all about being happy. Now, if a woman really wanted a man, she would be asking a man what he wants. She wouldn't be gathered around a whole bunch of bitches sitting around talking about men. You would want to talk to the man that you're interested in and ask him what does he want in a woman. You know what I'm saying? What does he like? What does he not like? What is he whatever? Right. And that's how, you know, you could get you a man, at least that man that you're interested in. You know what I'm saying? And vice versa. You know what I'm saying? With the man and the woman. You know what I'm saying? This ain't no cookie cut group shit. You know how everybody try to generalize shit like that, because everybody's different and everybody want different things. But you know what I'm saying, man, y'all go ahead, man.
I was going to say this too. That's what you call selling your soul. Yes. So when you get into a relationship and you know for a fact that this bitch was a whole lot of prostitutes, so you're basically selling or trading those energies, and now look what happened. He can't blame nothing but himself.
Soul ties. Exactly.
Right. Okay? Yeah.
No,
discussing, you know, how he found out about it. And it was because he was seeing someone else. And I was like, well, fuck it. And I was mad at him because how could you be mad at me for having an OnlyFans page when you're literally like sticking your dick in somebody else?
Oh, so he was seeing, like, he was
seriously cheating on me. Like, I have text messages of their conversations.
Now, man, you know, cheating, when we look up the definition of cheating, right, it's only cheating if you don't know, sis. It's cheating if you find out. If you allow it to go on, it's no longer cheating, sis. If you stay and allow this man to be in a full-blown relationship and stick his thing, like you telling us, then why did you stay, man? And this be the shit I be wondering. Like, don't tell me what they doing. Tell me what the fuck be in you that have you stay and endure and tolerate this shit that the motherfucker is doing to you.
You think cheating was the reason why a prostitute like this would step out on a nigga?
No.
Hold on, with that said, well, hold on. Absolutely. Fucking great timing, yo.
Can you please stop balling up and falling up so we can't even figure out what it is? It's gonna be a dollar just laid out in there. It's all right. It won't hurt. We had to go to Family Dollar and buy iron. To iron out all the dollars, so we can't even tell what they are. I work in the trustee ministry, and we're trying to go to Golden Corral too. By the time we iron out all the dollars, everything is closed. We don't even cook on Sunday no more. So just lay it in the plate. It's still gonna be a dollar. Amen. Come on, y'all. Let's just get along. Come on. Help us out. Because we ushers. We ushers. Amen. We're here to serve you. And no.
Hey, now check this out. Wasn't she? I mean, because I heard a little bit of this. I heard a little bit of this Puffy shit. I heard a little bit of this Keke Palmer shit. And with this bitch right here, wasn't she going overseas performing and shit or something?
Yeah, she said she had a house overseas.
So where was Joe at? Was Joe overseas with her? Where was the kids at? You see what I'm saying? So for her to say he was putting his dick in other females, well, he been putting his dick in other females ever since a nigga got to the league. And other niggas been putting a dick in you ever since you got into porn. And probably before that. So... this is the contradiction of a tramp and a hoe trying to be jealous of their man, because first of all, for you to even have the audacity to talk about this man cheating on you, what do you think you do every day when you parade yourself like this, when you make yourself readily available for dudes to contact you online or in person or whatever? Because I heard she was like parlaying this shit into going on dates and shit too.
Bro, did you see the video? Did you see the mini video that I? Oh man,
Yeah. I seen some videos, but I mean, I don't know what particular video you're talking about, but. I'm just telling you what my knowledge of what's going on with this situation from the shit I've seen. So for you to, or for any prostitute type bitch or stripper type bitch or whatever to try to act like you jealous of your man's actions and you're not looking at your actions, you're condoning this and you think your man should condone this because you call it your so-called job to do this, then, you know, it's like, it's kind of like any kind of dude that accepts that, you don't got that bitch. The bitch got you.
Zion Williamson, I hope you heard this, man.
All these niggas need to open up.
Any nigga. I'm talking about square broke ass nigga that you got, because there's a bunch of niggas around here and they got bitches on social media right now. And she got a picture of her and not a picture of you on there. She might have a picture of her and a baby, but not you on there. It's bitches that got so many DMs that you don't know about that, you know what I'm saying? There's just no way that a female can be in pocket right now. So don't get to thinking just because these niggas is going through it and they on social media and they, you know, was famous and shit like that. These regular niggas is going through it too. So what I'm saying is when your bitch got more homeboys than you do, you need to look at your situation.
Y'all better watch that bud, man. Y'all better watch that bud, man. I feel sorry for those of y'all who, y'all girls smoke weed. Sheesh.
Yeah, smoke weed. She like tab. All...
She's gonna have to go free.
And did you?
Yeah.
It don't matter if she's smoking weed or sipping on some Jamba Juice. It don't matter what she doing. If your bitch got more homeboys than you do, something ain't right. Because if any nigga, think about this. Say a nigga come up and say, "Hey man, where your girl? Oh, she kicking it with her homeboy right now." You know what I'm saying? How does that shit sound?
Preach, love.
You know that he was cheating on you when you started your OnlyFans, or was it a coincidence?
No, that was totally secret. I didn't do that in spite.
Okay.
Me having this argument online was in spite.
So how long did you keep the OnlyFans a secret?
I managed to do it for about a year.
Wow, so you had your OnlyFans for a year before he found out.
Uh-huh.
And what made him find out? Like, did he search you up online or?
No, honestly, I think she just told him.
Oh, wow.
That she had one. I had one, sorry. I think she told him, yeah.
The woman he was seeing.
And then he went and found it for himself and.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I feel like, that's probably information that not everybody knows. I mean, because everyone's kind of online.
Everyone's making their own assumptions about what, you know, why I did it, what it is, you know, but no one really knows.
Right. Okay. So you had it for about a year before he found out. How were you keeping it a secret? Didn't you have to make content and stuff? Were you
I was like putting up old pictures, or I'll take pictures by myself. Like if you look at my content from then to now, it's like really different. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
Were you like secretly sneaking away to
the... She said, if you look at my content from then to now, it's really different. Because when you were sneaking, you had all that bullshit up there. Now that it's all out, the cat is out the bag, and you get to do what you really want to do now. Now you got motherfucking lights, camera, action out this motherfucker. Y'all.
And that, man. And that goes to show you how long their relationship been fucked up. If you could be sneaky like that and make content for a year, that shit was fucked up before that. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, that just goes to show you, man, how sneaky a motherfucker can be, man. They can be doing all kind of shit behind your back for a year. But that just goes to show you how the relationship wasn't close. You know what I'm saying? Because what this nigga in the living room watching the game, the bitch in the back room doing content and shit. Hey, baby, what you doing? You know what I'm saying? he just interrupted her live.
Yo,
you know what I'm saying? Nigga walk in, the bitch in a bikini and shit. Like, what you doing in the bikini in the house during the day? You know what I'm saying? Like, when were you doing this content? Y'all couldn't have been together. And if another bitch is the one to put him up on game, then this nigga don't even realize what was going on in his household. And didn't even know what was going. He wasn't even in tune with his bitch.
Right.
Yeah.
That just go to show you, man. This
just seemed like one of them relationships where she seen the nigga struggling with the last baby, with his baby moms. You know what I mean? And she seen her getting them, and she came and moseyed on right on up and tickled his chin, because y'all talked about it earlier. She damn sure do got the skills of the professional tin tickler. And she just got right up under him, tickled his chin right as he, you know what I mean? She caught him on the downside, though. She caught him and just cleaned him out. She's cleaned out.
That don't necessarily mean she pursued him. He could have pursued her.
Well, they pursued each other in any event. She knew he was a ball player, so she knew what was going on. She knew what time it was. She was looking for the come up, the quick fix. And, you know, where I get that theory from is because he was in a custody battle. He was in a divorce with his previous wife before he got into it with this lady. I don't think these two got any kids. There's three kids documented, but I think those are prior to them meeting each other. She might have one, he have two with the old bitch, but they don't have any kids together. So that's another red flag. She ain't got with this nigga for no love and for no family. She got with the nigga because he was an ex-ball player.
Right. And another thing, I'm going to tell you what she's doing herself a disservice, right? she's trying to justify why she's doing this because she's doing bad. That's terrible marketing. You shouldn't be telling your audience you need them like that. That's how you're gonna get lowballed, bitch.
Dummy. You right though.
You're already an old bitch. You know what I'm saying? But like, come on, man. Whatever you did back in the days when you first started porn, I mean, old news don't make today's headline. You know what I'm saying? You an old bitch now. Stop trying to, you know what I'm saying? This desperation and all this shit. We doing bad and all that, whatever, right? And as far as Joe is concerned, Joe is a 16-year NBA vet. Nigga, you played 4 years in college and you're 16 years in the motherfucking league. Nigga, most of your homeboys is coaches right now. You mean to tell me you can't get on a motherfucker? Fucking college staff or NBA staff, nigga. You can't teach power forwards the game. There ain't no excuse why this nigga. Niggas should be broke. You know what I'm saying? You can get your motherfucking ass in the league, nigga, and be an assistant coach somewhere.
Yeah, she blew him up too. She said when the lockout happened, he never made the effort to go get his ass up. He probably would have been on the bench. He probably would have had a couple, three, four more years to run it up, but.
I'm talking about as we speak right now. As far as the experience you got. And the credentials you got on your resume, nigga, you can go get you a assistant coaching job. You got homeboys. You got relationships in the league. You ain't no Kwame Brown. Type nigga. You wasn't a weird ass nigga in the league. You got skills to offer.
Right. It sounds like Joe might be a little lazy, man, and you know his motivation
It sound like he wrapped up into this bitch too much. Nigga, it's you need it. To go or whatever. Ever, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I don't know what homeboys you got, man, but it's one of these niggas need to go and chop your ass up, nigga, and wake your ass up and, you know, get the fuck up out of this situation. And man, go try to fill out an application somewhere.
All right, bye, Yaki. All right, black man. All right. You know what I'm saying? QMO, like, I feel you on that. But come on, at the same time, a man is only as strong as a woman. And at the same time, what was she doing to help motivate him in any kind of way, in form, fashion? She could talk about how she started all these entrepreneurs or business and shipping all this other. Come on now.
Yo, that's why I love good brides, be good brides. Everybody get this.
Man, first of all, he should be stronger than a woman.
No, I get it. I get it, but at the same time, like, I don't know their situation, but I look at it like this. She was a gold digger from the start. Like, you know what I'm saying? Was balling boy before he was. You know what I'm saying? But on the flip side of that too, like when I don't know.
No,
like,
No, she ain't never touched the money. Honey, he touched.
Exactly. That's the whole part. He was.
But you said she was balling before he was.
Right. I'm just saying it. Balling.
Balling like balling with money?
No, balling in the industry, the promo industry. She was balling already.
But she wasn't at the level he was in the NBA though.
Correct. And he was always gonna make more money. So
right.
She weakens him. Put it like that. She weakens him and weakens the motherfucking pockets and everything else. Now they looking at each other like they stupid. Oh no, I'm going to find a way. Let me spread these legs. Come on.
Yeah, but even with her doing what she doing, if what I suggested, him getting into the league, being an assistant coach, getting with one of his former colleagues or whatever, getting in, would make more money than she could ever make on OnlyFans, especially at this point.
Right. And I was going to say that's why he probably cheated, because she wasn't really being a woman that he needed her to be from the start.
Yeah, but I mean, is this about cheating or is this about, well, I mean, what is this, their whole story about? It can't just be about cheating. It's about more than that. It's just about her being exposed to doing OnlyFans, and he didn't know, and now he's upset about it. Is that what it is?
You know, this. I'm gonna tell you what the whole narrative is now. We're going to peel back the onion. This is what they want black love to be, bro. They want black love to be where you get with a bitch and you
love her
whatever she want and you fund it. You know what I mean? You fund it. And if she get crazy on you, you bet not.
No, bro. Hold on. You said they. Who is they?
Society, bro. Bro, you how many lives we done there, bro?
I know, but
my whole ideology.
I know. That's why I got to ask you questions, because when you say they, I don't know who you're talking about. I'm talking about these two people. What was the whole thing about them being, I mean, this right here, this whole situation going viral? Was it about him finding out she was doing OnlyFans behind his back? Because it wasn't about cheating. I mean, we just heard in her little interviews some about cheating or whatever, but that's not what went viral. Was about her doing OnlyFans, right?
Yeah.
I believe it was.
Yeah. And she wanted this. She wanted it to come out, yo. She wanted it to come out. This This is her plan from the
Yeah, she the one that put it out, put it viral. And see, the thing is, I think that was a part of the marketing.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? For her. You know, and it wasn't society, it was her that videotaped this and put it out. But
yeah, but what she markets, you gotta realize the younger, and the crazy thing is she getting the fucking information from a fucking daughter. So yeah, it's like the younger generation,
Yeah, but to tie in what I said and what it's talking about with when I said society. We have a campaign that is marketing this strong and independent woman shit, where women are to be strong and independent and emasculate the man. That's what this play into. This play into, if you look at the same blueprint, let's play into the same blueprint with the Keke Palmer situation, where she got, it's okay for her to get up there and dance naked on Usher, right? And then when her husband say something about it, he's weak, he's insecure. So this goes into the same thing where these bitches want to be okay with.
Was she married, or is that just her baby daddy?
Who?
Keke Palmer.
Would it matter? Would it matter?
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, it does matter.
That's a baby father. How about that? That's a baby father.
I mean, the question is a question.
So I don't know if they married or not, but that is his baby mama went up there and danced without clothes. It's the same blueprint, though, bro.
Right.
What's difficult about it?
You don't. It's the same blueprint. Is what?
It's the same blueprint as let the bitch do whatever she want, and you stand there and fund it. That's what I said. That's what the
he complained about it. He didn't condone it.
All right. And society shunned him. They painted him out to be the bad guy because
he You mean the sisterhood or the sisterhood and society is two different things. Of course, black bitches is going to side with Keke.
Yeah, but there's also
the minority of black women are going to side with the man because they know that Keke was in the wrong.
What do you want to debate about, DeBell?
It ain't a debate.
All right, so what are we
talking about? It ain't no debate.
All right, so I don't understand, because society is separate from sisterhood, because society includes the sisterhood, simps, everybody. You know what I mean? The sisterhood have the sisterhood. You know what I mean?
Society, yeah, but what you her siding with Kiki wasn't society, it was the sisterhood.
Oh, mm-hmm. Now that's where we disagree. And I disagree. It's society, because it's some simps that is siding with Kiki also. So it's men that is siding with Kiki,
and they are considered sisterhood. I don't consider them niggas men. I mean, any nigga that side with some bitch ass shit is a bitch ass nigga.
All right, cool. Nigga dumb. So nah, you getting them niggas ain't in the sisterhood, bro. Them niggas are just dumb. Them niggas they're on their own island.
But yeah, man. Yeah, this shit is crazy, man.
The facts though, man. Guys, yo, y'all got anything y'all want to add before we go on to wrap this thing on up? I got to get to this this old hellified mother, yo, this hell of a mother, Blueface Moms. Calista. You know what I mean?
All I got to say is, ladies, make the money. Don't let the money make you.
They not gonna listen. They're just not gonna listen to you. They're gonna be like, fuck her, she a hick me. She's a hick me.
Hey, but can I ask how they making money though?
They just got to move their minds.
No. I'm talking about how are they making the money?
I mean, you already know $40 for a little.
Off a man, right?
Yeah, just, you know, dribble the
ball. So a man got to fund this campaign.
Yes, they got to fund up. Yes, that's right. I need the nails. I need the this. I need the lace wigs. I need that.
Okay. Yeah, so we need the cooperation of tricks to make the money. Make the
money. Guys, yo, tricks guys, I want to see y'all investing in yourself more. I don't want to see y'all investing, you know what I mean, in these women. You know what I mean? Everybody's got to take the time for themselves. Everybody got to fend for themselves at this point, guys. Everybody needs to really pour into them. Take they little dollars and pour into them. Fuck all this sponsoring people shit, bro. Because right about now, y'all niggas don't even know love. Y'all don't know love. Y'all niggas, if God came back down here today and said, yo, I give you back everything you invested in this bitch, y'all niggas would leave the bitch. Y'all wouldn't even care about the bitch no more. It's because y'all just care about your investments at this point. Have some of y'all niggas, y'all send up her crib, y'all done bought a living room set. You know what I mean? So you ain't even worried about the bitch. You worried about that living room set now. You can't leave the crib. You can't get your shit together because you bought her living room set. You know what I mean? When you could have spent half that money on your self-improvement and bought yourself an airbag and took your ass to the shelter and been good. You know what I mean? You got to start thinking, guys. Remember, decision-making is a skill. Build that skill, bro, and it come with facts. You got to go get to the facts. Y'all making decisions off of stupid shit, off of misled information, bro, secondhand information. That's not good. Y'all got anything y'all want to add, guys? BT, starting with you. BT, I guess BT doing something right now. All right, Bella B., got anything you want to add?
I just want to say to the men, just know your worth and know your values.
and add some sense to it in certain situations. Stay focused and stay grounded, because there's a beast out there.
It's a war going on outside. No man is safe from BZ, man. Close it on out, man. MVP.
Hey, man. I'm coming out with hashtags, man. Separate the bitch from a pussy. Hashtag that. Hashtag boycott a bitch. If a nigga can do that for if a nigga can do that for about a week, I know you niggas ain't got the discipline, because that trick spirit is real deep in you, man. It's deep centered in you. For some reason, man, you're gonna have to either go by a graveyard where some pimps was buried, or go write a nigga that's in jail right now for pimping and pandering and be a pen pal or something like that, man. But you're gonna have to hit my Cash App, man, if you gonna keep getting this game, man. But hey, man, I mean the shit is just gonna keep continuing and continuing, because there's so many avenues for a prostitute right now. This internet is giving bitches a voice. Is giving a bunch of simp square ass niggas a voice to complain about a bitch, and it's in the same breath you complaining, you hitting a bitch's Cash App. You're paying bitches that you can't even smell, logging onto her OnlyFans. You can't touch the bitch. You can't even smell the bitch's perfume, and you're paying like a dumbass. Nigga, you might as well go to a strip joint and spend some money. At least you can dry hump the bitch. But I mean, you know, niggas is gonna continue to keep doing stupid shit, and I mean, you know, it is what it is, man. So it's like when you go to the zoo, you see that sign, don't feed the animals, you nigga just keep doing it. And you think this animal, the more you feed this animal, he ain't gonna bite you. But it's still an animal, nigga. Jump on the other side of that fence, nigga, and get your ass toe up. And that's what you tricks has been doing. You've been getting your ass toe up. And then you want to get to the internet and get to crying and talk about what a bitch done did and all this old type of shit. But I mean, it is what it is.
It's crazy.
BZ, the Bell 503, you know.
You got to remember, Bell, they pops what? Used to phone chat with a bitch. They used to spend money on a bitch, run up their grandma bill without even getting a chance to see the pussy.
So, well, I mean, the kids didn't know nothing about that. That was when the niggas was young.
You know what I mean? So these
the kids didn't see that. But the kids did see a different nigga in their mama's bedroom every night.
It's in their system, boy. It's in their system. Them Sims got it in their system, boy. This shit is inherited. That Sim shit is inherited. Yeah, y'all get to some masculinity, man. All right, get to that other side of the story. And you forgot one hashtag, BZ. Hashtag put papers on the bitch, man.
Absolutely. Absolutely. My nigga.
We out of here, guys. Y'all wrap up, strap up, drink responsibly. Do not play with your life, man.
Yes, indeed. That was my partner, Mr. Goodbread. I had to go over there, man, and tap in. That was Mr. Goodbread Reactions and Mr. Goodbread Brutally Honest. Go tap in with them channels right there, man. But anyways, this has been the Bell 503. You know what I'm saying? Just kicking some of this shit, man, with my peoples. And you know what I'm saying? Tap in, hit the like, hit the share, hit that Cash App, and hit that subscribe. Peace.